The Section 5 Sportsmanship Committee and New York State Public High School Athletic Association are proud to present Be Loud, Be Proud, Be Positive. Cheer for your team, respect your opponent, refrain from negative personal comments about players, coaches, or officials. Be loud, be proud, be positive. Section 5, the Livingston Athletic Conference and Dansville Central School District, thank you for your cooperation. Spectators are reminded there's no smoking on school grounds at any time. Please throw all trash and cans placed throughout the complex. No spectators are allowed inside the track fest area or behind the team benches. Noisemakers are prohibited during all Section 5 contests. Thank you for your cooperation. The All Sports Group Booster Club concession stand will be open throughout tonight's contest.
Scarlett told me to go there.
It's going to be a game when we get there, and I really enjoy things to be competitive. I don't like to win 8-0, you know, so I like to score close, and I like to have to look for it. So they're usually a team that we have to battle a little bit. They're pretty physical sometimes, athletic, typically, and you know.
I'm
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Dansville for tonight's contest between the visiting Livonia Lady Bulldogs and our Dansville Lady Mustangs. Now for the starting lineup for Livonia Bulldogs. Number one, Mary Kwok. Number three, Olivia Feehan. Number four, Caitlin Haw. Number seven, Haley Weldy. Number eight, Hannah Weldy. Number nine, Kendall Kretschmer. Number 10, Eliza Parker. Number 12, Michaela Pavanich. Number 14, Haley Kuhn. Number 20, Sophia Otis. Number 25, Avery Bernard. And the rest of the Lady Bulldogs, coached by Jennifer Buckley.
Ooh, you gotta go.
Now introducing the starting lineup for Dansville Lady Mustangs. Number zero, Emma Butters. Number two, Callie Little. Number three, Bailey Hayes. Number four, Treva Wadsworth. Number eight, Taylor Hampshire. Number nine, Kaylee Meyer. Number 10, Megan Tyler. Number 12, Chelsea Tyler. Number 14, Ainsley Belcher. Number 16, Eleni Mountzoris. Number 17, Emma Allen. And the rest of the Lady Mustangs, coached by Aaron Belden. To honor America and those that serve and have served, please rise for the national anthem.
For both ball clubs, sponsored in part by Dansville Auto Mart at 9976 Main Street in Dansville, your full service dealer. From sales to major and minor repairs, they can do it all. Family owned and operated for over 45 years. See Dansville Auto Mart the next time you need a vehicle or repair work done on your vehicle, or call 585-335-8280. And Dansville Water Systems on the Hornell Road in Dansville, just south of 390. They can take care of all of your water problems, whether it smells bad, has bacteria in it, is hard, or leaves stains. They have pool and hot tub supplies, a well-stocked archery shop, and they've got sheds for sale, too. That's Dansville Water Systems on the Hornell Road in Dansville, just south of 390 at Exit 4. And Better Homes at 13 Ossian Street in Dansville with a huge selection of furniture in stock. Get rid of the saggy sofa, throw out the broken recliner and that worn-out mattress, too. They have got an inventory like you wouldn't believe. And better service, too. Better quality, better service, Better Homes, 13 Ossian Street in Dansville. First of all, for the Livonia Bulldogs out there, one of the forwards will be Olivia Feehan. Caitlin Hall will be at midfield. Haley Weldy and Hannah Weldy, midfield and forward, respectively. Kendall Kretschmer on the defense. She is a senior. Eliza Parker, one of the forwards. Also in the starting lineup, Michaela Prabanich. She will be on defense. Haley Kuhn, also back on defense. At midfield, Sophia Otis and Avery Bernard back on D, Mary Kwok in goal, and this high school soccer game underway here at the reconfigured sports complex. As for Dansville, Callie Little, Bailey Hayes, Trevor Wadsworth out there, along with Taylor Hampshire back on defense, Kaylee Meyer, Megan Tyler, and Chelsea Tyler, along with Ainsley Belcher, Eleni Montezoris, and Emma Allen, and in goal, Emma Butters for Aaron Belden's team. Handling it out front, Olivia Feehan feeds it into the middle where Dansville takes over. Bailey Hayes controls it, swings a pass up the left side wing, but it's going to be tracked down over there by Haley Kuhn. Livonia wearing their road white jerseys with blue numerals trimmed in orange. Dansville in their home reds with white numerals trimmed in black. And Dansville moving from left to right. And, of course, Livonia in the opposite direction as we are underway here at the reconfigured sports complex in Dansville. Ball is checked back out to midfield and will roll across the sideline on the near side. It'll be a throw-in for the Dansville Lady Mustangs where Treva Wadsworth tosses it in down toward the right side. Ball challenged and taken away by Caitlin Haw. Or make it Olivia Feehan, who zips a long pass over the top on the far side. Callie Little comes up with it for the Mustangs, trying to exploit the far sideline. Ball tipped, kept in by the Livonia defense, and they try to go over the top with it up the right sideline. Bodying it down, the Bulldogs try and bring it back in, and Dansville sends it over to the sideline where Aaron Belden gets a foot on it. She did her share in Warsaw, I can tell you that. In her day, unquestionably. Ball comes back deep. Bulldogs putting some pressure on a front right-footed shot. One hopped and taken out there that time by Emma Butters. So Livonia challenges early, and Butters comes up with her first save of the ball game. It looked like Olivia Feehan got a shot off that time, and point-blank range, too, pretty much, but didn't get all of it. It has been raining here on and off at the reconfigured corral here in Dansville. Ball taken out front by Sophia Otis, sends a pass through the middle, gets it back to the near side. Haley Weldy bodies it down, and Dansville finally takes it away on the near side. Wadsworth sends it up the right side, looking that time for Kaylee Meyer, but over everybody. Throwing it back in will be Kendall Kretschmer on the near side for Livonia. About 3 minutes in, scoreless ball game. Livonia and Dansville will have the same pairing tomorrow night in homecoming soccer action as the boys will take center stage here. We'll have the game live for you right here on 105.7 WDNY, starting with a pregame show at about 6:15, so we hope you'll join us. Ball in the back, some contact on the far side, and the ball gets away near the top of the box. Checked away, right side, coming out to get it is Emma Butters, alertly. That ball squirted through the Dansville defense, and one of the Bulldogs was bearing down in the box looking for a shot, and Butters aggressively came out and foiled the plan and came up with a loose ball. Scoreless game, 36-24 left to play here in the first half. On the far side, ball set back up on the right side wing, hustling to the right side corner. It's Olivia Feehan. Feehan looks to feed it back into the middle, goes over the top. Mustangs chase it down across midfield. Bringing it right side that time was Taylor Hampshire into the middle. On the far side, the Bulldogs control and a long pass down the right side wing, and Emma Butters is going to come out and get it right in front of the goal mouth. So the Bulldogs get a couple of shots off here in the first 5 minutes of play, but nothing that finds the back of the net. Ball in the middle taken there by Eleni Montezoris, and now over the top, Emma Allen sends it deep on the left side, a foot race on the far side. Megan Tyler gets there, sends it in, but the Bulldogs send it back out. Eliza Parker got a piece of it, send it up the left side wing. Coming over to get it, Ainsley Belcher feeds it back in the middle, in back as Danzo will come near side. Ball taken away by Olivia Feehan. The sophomore forward takes it to the left side corner, looking to position something for the Bulldogs, sends it back out front, little touch pass. Feehan's right-footed shot cross, diving save by Emma Butters. So they got a shot away on the near side. Haley Weldy got one, and Feehan on the assist, but a diving save made that time by Emma Butters, her third of the ball game unofficially. Midfield, they come near side for Chelsea Tyler. The ball squirts through, and the Bulldogs take it away. A battle at midfield on the left side as Eleni Montezoris booted it on the far side, coming to get it there for Livonia. I believe it's Haley Kuhn on that side. Tough to tell from our vantage point here in Dansville, at least not without any binoculars or glasses. Left side wing, the ball fed back out. Treva Wadsworth sends it back to the Livonia defense, and the Bulldogs will bring it upfield on the near side. Michaela Prebanich got a piece of it and sent it back, and the ball comes out near side. It'll be thrown back in by Kendall Kretschmer for Livonia. 7 minutes into the action, scoreless ball game. Couple of substitutes checking in. Rory Flickner for the Livonia Bulldogs. Maya Hayes enters as well for the Dansville Lady Mustangs. Ball thrown in by Kendall Kretschmer. Action here in the first period or first half, also sponsored in part by Dansville Radiator at 9989 Main Street, where they've got a great selection of used cars specializing in AC recharge and repair. They've got storage sets for sale or for order. Stop by soon to Dansville Radiator at 9989 Main Street in Dansville. Far side throw-in coming up for the Dansville Mustangs, and they'll toss it in to the far side corner to try to bring it toward the end line. Chasing it over there is Michaela Prebanich, battling for it in the corner, digs it out finally, and the Bulldogs pushing it up the right side wing. Ball bodied down, and Dansville gets it back. Right-footed shot is deflected out front by the Bulldogs, as it looked like Emma Allen got a shot away, but blocked a good 30 yards away. But Wadsworth sends it back in, and Feehan deflects it back the other way. Bulldogs on the approach. They try to go over the top. Ainsley Belcher gets a piece of it. Leaves it near side, and the ball steered out on a throw-in coming up for Livonia. Probably about 20, 25 yards out on the left-hand side where Kendall Kretschmer tosses it into the left side corner. Looking down there for Haley Weldy, and the ball goes out once again. Getting a piece of it, Eleni Montezoris in the left side corner for Dansville, and Feehan will toss it in about 15 yards away. Looking for the left-footed shot that time, Kirsten Einhippel, and the ball taken off her foot. Feehan will throw it back in as Dansville's defense swarmed the ball. Left side, ball trickles in and sent back up right side, near side that time by Eleni Montezoris, and it'll be thrown back in once more, this time about 30 yards away for Kendall Kretschmer and the Livonia Bulldogs. Ball brought back out front. Feehan making the approach on the left. Now cuts back between two defenders, taking it toward the top. Right-footed shot goes through the crease, and Butters is there for the save. Fourth shot for Livonia. Fourth save for Emma Butters. 9 minutes into the game, we're still scoreless. Nothing, nothing, as Dansville and Livonia battle it out here in the drizzly conditions at the reconfigured corral. Right side, it's Hannah Weldy with it in the middle. Ball touched away. Weldy with a left-footed shot, left side post, and right there again, Emma Butters. So Livonia slicing some holes in that Dansville defense. They have outshot Dansville in the early going in this game, 5-0. So the Bulldog defense, you might want to call them the Orange Crushed at this point in time. Livonia opened the season falling 1-0 to Leroy. They lost 4-2 to Hornell and then turned things around on the road when they defeated Midlakes 2-0. And then just last night, they and Penn Yan played to a scoreless tie. So back-to-back nights for Jen Bugby's ball club. But they are raring to go. They certainly have come out with a lot of energy early on. Some fresh bodies entering in for the Bulldogs on the far side as Kendall Kretschmer among one of two players leaving. Checking in, Kiara Wilson on the right-hand side. Ball checked back out front. And a long shot on the right side to cross the right side of the goal mouth to the left, and Feehan chases it down before it goes into the corner. Right side, caroms it in there. Ball dropped momentarily, but Butters comes up with it on the rebound. Ball squirted through Emma Butters' hands, but she came right back up with it, almost like she dribbled it like a basketball and kept her body between herself and the goal mouth. So Livonia with their sixth shot, long pass over the top of the Bulldog defense, but Bulldogs get back real quickly. On the right side, quick touch pass by Montesoris is sent back out by Livonia. Montesoris takes it away again, sends it in the middle. Right side sending it over the top, Emma Allen to the left side wing where the Bulldogs will control it there. Action also sponsored in part by Dansville Muffler and Brake at 9 Spruce Street in Dansville. If your vehicle needs repair work done, be sure to stop in and see Jim Hart or give him a call, 585-335-8860, a proud sponsor of high school sports on WDNY. Dansville Muffler and Brake at 9 Spruce Street. Long boot over the top as Emma Butters came up with that loose ball in front of the goal mouth and boots it back to midfield. Throw-in coming up. Kiara Wilson, the junior defender on the near side, gets it in. Emma Allen returns it right where it came from, and Wilson will try it once more. Gets it over the top this time, and Allen sends it right back up here. We almost got a souvenir, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Emma. Action also sponsored in part by the Law Office of John C. Putney at 149 Main Street in Dansville, providing a wide array of legal services. That's the Law Office of John C. Putney. Left side corner, Weldy has the ball deflected out, and it'll be a corner kick coming up, it looks like. First corner kick of the ball game coming up for the Livonia Bulldogs, and Haley Weldy will boot it away from the left side corner. No, check that. It's going to be Olivia Feehan. So Olivia Feehan, right foot from the left side corner. First corner kick of the ball game coming up for the Bulldogs at 27-24, near side post. Ball squirts through the middle and set back the other way and out. Is it a goal kick or a corner kick? It looks like it'll be a corner kick again. Once again, it was touched by the Dansville Mustangs last. No, on second thought, it's a goal kick. Now they send it back out the other way. So Dansville will boot it out of there as Emma Butters will get play back underway from the near side, sends it back to midfield. The ball volleyed out on the left side by Kiara Wilson. Throw-in coming up on the near side. I believe it's Treva Wadsworth who tosses it in. She does. And trying to spin her way out there, Kaylee Meyer. Left side, ball loose in the middle and pushed up on the left-hand side. Faith Mutchler into the action for the Mustangs. Long pass up the left side wing in a foot race over there. Megan Tyler has the ball knocked away. Looked like it was Haley Kuhn that deflected away. Dansville on the quick throw in, and the Bulldogs break it up on the far sideline. They get the ball back loose coming over the top. Right side, it is Kaylee Meyer, brings it back to the middle. Double team squirting through the double team. Mustangs give it back. Meyer again going right to left, looking for the left side wing. Quick touch, pushes it to the left side corner, looking for the shot there. Ball is deflected away toward the top of the box. Two offensive players there. Mustangs trying to get a shot away in the left side of the box. And a little chip shot in the middle. Ball is headed back out by the Bulldog defense. And on the run, Olivia Feehan gets a piece of it, but Wadsworth sends it back in on the left-hand side. Dansville challenging, but the ball last touched by Livonia. Dansville will throw it in, maybe about 15 yards away on the right side. Eleni Montezoris, the junior midfielder, gets it in quickly. Right-hand side, it's Kaylee Meyer taking it to the end line, trying to circle a pass in. Near side post, ball loose in the middle, shot up and over the top. Oh, so close, but so far, Mustangs on the doorstep. 25-10 left to play here in the first half. It's Dansville nothing, Livonia nothing.
Jim from Dansville Muffler and Brake wishes both teams the best of luck. And the next time you need quality work done on your vehicle, see Dansville Muffler and Brake. With a 4.7 Google rating, you can trust the professionals at Dansville Muffler and Brake to get the job done quickly and right the first time. Dansville Muffler and Brake is located just off Main Street at 9 Spruce Street, and their number is 585-335-8860.
High school sports on WDNY.
Olivia Feehan splits a shot from the top of the box, and it's saved by Emma Butters. Butters with her seventh save. Livonia with seven shots to Dansville's one. Dansville on the doorstep moments ago, and instead of finding the net, they went up and over and hit the football goal post instead. And they didn't get 3 points for it either if they got it through. So 24 minutes left to play here in this scoreless first half as Livonia and Dansville, Livingston County Division I matchup, rolls on here at the reconfigured corral. Left side, Dansville trying to make an approach, and the ball is deflected out of bounds on the far side by Rory Flickner. But a throw-in coming up for, is it for Dansville or is it for Livonia? Substitutions taking place over there, and it looks like it's going to be a Livonia throw-in, and I believe it's Rory Flickner tossing it in over there on the far side in the left side corner for the Livonia Bulldogs. Action here in the first half, sponsored in part by Napa of Dansville and Mount Morris. For all the parts you need to keep your vehicle running in tip-top shape, it's Napa Auto Parts at 11 Ocean Street in Dansville and 140 North Main Street in Mount Morris. Kevin and his staff will help you get the right part the first time, every time at Napa. Ball sent out on the near side as the ball got back into the Dansville defense. Throw in coming up for Livonia. Feehan gets it in on the left side and gets the ball back from Haley Weldy. They send it off the pass on the right side. Left-footed shot, and Butters is there and gets it. As the Bulldogs took a loose ball and got a shot away, but couldn't find the back of the net. Caitlin Haw pulled the trigger on that one, and Emma Butters with her eighth save unofficially. Left side, ball deflected back out by Feehan. Coming out to get the loose ball is Emma Butters. Emma will boot it out of there. 22-23 left to play here in half number one, scoreless game. Girls soccer on 105.7 WDNY. Tomorrow night, the boys do it up. Then Friday night, homecoming football action. Ball squirts through the defense. Foot race on in front of the goal mouth, right-hand side, looking for the shot. Maya Hayes trying to get it back out of there, but Livonia takes it away. So the Bulldogs swarm the soccer ball in the back of the box that time. Maya Hayes won the foot race, got a piece of that ball, but couldn't get the shot away. Had a lot of momentum going toward the end line, but couldn't pull the trigger on the shot. So throw in also triggers a couple of substitutions as the Mustangs will throw it in. Kaylee Meyer gets it in on the near side. Quick touch pass in the middle to Maya Hayes again, and Livonia takes away right side. Hayes gets it once more, trying to weave between defenders, and the ball set back out by the Bulldogs defensively, trying to send it back in on the near side. One of the DNL Mustangs, Treva Wadsworth. Wadsworth into the corner, Kaylee Meyer after it, and the Bulldogs push it out once more. Scoreless game, 21 minutes left to play in half number one. Listening to girls soccer on 105.7 WDNY. Meyer has the ball headed back out near side. Olivia Feehan takes it away, and the ball taken away from behind by Danzo. Right-footed shot. One hopper taken by Mary Kwok, as I believe it was Chelsea Tyler who pulled the trigger on that one. So Kwok with her first save. Dansville with their second shot in the game. Livonia out shooting Dansville 8-2 at this point in time, but still no score in the ball game, and that's the most important part. Ball sent back out. Avery Bernard back on defense for Livonia to midfield. The ball thrown back in by the Mustangs. Left side pass into the corner. Maya Hayes on a foot race for the left-hand side. Trying to make something happen there. Leaves it in the corner. Left-footed crossing pass deflected out of there by the Bulldogs. Again sent back in the middle. Ball squirts through. Ball still loose. Left-hand side as they try to dig it out of there. Ball toward the end line, and out it goes, and it will be a corner kick coming up for the Dansville Mustangs, their first of the ball game. So Dansville with a corner kick. It looks like Emma Allen will put the ball in play from the left-hand side with a right-footed shot. 19:36 and counting in a scoreless first half. Allen from the left side corner. Mustangs set themselves up, and Allen puts the foot to it and angles it to the near side post. Ball bodied out by the Bulldogs. Right-footed shot put back, and it's scored! Ball! A goal for the Dansville Mustangs. Not sure who pulled the trigger on it over there, but Dansville has taken a 1-0 lead. So at 19:17 left, try and find out who that was that scored that goal. But Dansville grabs themselves a 1-0 lead off the volley, off the corner kick. Callie Little volleyed that one in, so Callie Little with a score for the Dansville Lady Mustangs with 19:17 left. So Callie Little.
Meyer have an assist on that? They just had Meyer's picture up there. No assist?
Callie Little credited with the goal, unassisted as far as we know. Right side pass into the corner. Dansville trying to dig it out. Dansville with a 1-0 lead. Left side, and the Bulldogs will toss it in. A lot of bodies over there on that far side, and all of a sudden, a ball comes shooting out of the pack and found the back of the net, and there were bodies everywhere. Long pass, sent back through, behind the Bulldog defense, going back to get it quickly, Michaela Probanich, and lucky she did, because the Mustangs were closing on that loose ball. A long pass into the middle, and the Bulldogs trying to pull it back out once again. Long shot, right foot, and Kwok has it. So Lainey Montezores pulls the trigger on one, and Kwok with her second save. So the shots, 8-4 in favor of Livonia, but the scoreboard reads Dansville 1-0 on the Callie Little goal from the left side top of the box, probably about, I want to say, maybe 17 yards out. Ball sent to the right side corner as Kaylee Meyer tries to root it out of there, and on the near side, the Bulldogs looking to bring it near side for Feehan, and it goes out, and Dansville will have a throw-in coming up. 17:18 left to play. Action sponsored in part by Tony's Pizzeria. Everybody loves crazy cheap pizza day at Tony's, and that's tomorrow, every Wednesday from noon to 8. Every large pizza is a small pizza price, even their specialty pizzas. Call and order anytime after 10 a.m. They're crazy busy at Tony's. 585-335-8984, Tony's Pizzeria at 140 Main Street in Dansville. Ball taken in back that time. After it, Megan Tyler spins down, and the ball coming back in, Treva Wadsworth will toss it in from about 20 yards out on the right side. Ball headed up on the near side by Chelsea Tyler and rooted back out toward midfield. Bodying it down near side, Ainsley Belcher goes over the top. Bulldogs send it back in the middle where Kirsten Einhippel sends it back in the middle. Quick touch pass. Caitlin Hall with a push on the left-hand side trying to sneak through the Dansville defense. Good sliding tackle there by Ainsley Belcher. Got rid of that ball to the far side. Mustangs trying to return it the other way, but it ends up in Aaron Belden's hands on the Dansville bench. Oh, throw in for Livonia right near midfield on the right-hand side. Toss down into the right side corner and bodies everywhere. The ball goes out, last touch by Dansville. Unassisted. So Kaylee Little right side, ball brought back out front. Defender was trying to clear that ball out on that goal by Callie Little, and Little came up with a loose ball and pulled the trigger on one. Wilson with a shot from about 20 yards out over the top. Ball is deflected out of there by the Dansville defense. Never made it to the back line. And Kaylee Meyer takes over, leaves it on the right side for Megan Tyler. Tyler has it sent back in the middle, and Treva Wadsworth tries to save it in but cannot do so. 15 minutes left to play in the first half. Action also sponsored by Dansville Dogwood Floral at 150 Main Street in Dansville. Flowers say so much, the staff at Dogwood Floral has the knowledge and expertise to take the stress out of sending flowers. Call 585-335-5170 or visit them online at dogwoodfloralcompany.com. Left side, ball checked to the corner. Kaylee Meyer trying to keep it in, or check it, it is Taylor Hampshire trying to keep it in, and it's going to go across the end line. Corner kick coming up for Livonia. And it looks like Olivia Feehan will boot it in, right foot from the left side corner. Second corner kick for Livonia in the ball game. Sends it up and into the middle. Ball knocked back out of there by the Dansville defense on the far side. I believe it was Emma Allen who got a piece of that and sent it out on the left. Ball back in the middle, and Livonia takes over with it offensively. A long shot over the top, one hopped by Emma Butters, and it was right on goal, too. A little quick scuff shot that time by Olivia Feehan, the sophomore forward, but right on the money, and Emma Butters credited with her ninth save. Ninth shot for Livonia. Dansville with four shots, and one of them has found the back of the net, and that's the difference in the ball game right now. Callie Little, unassisted at the 19-17 mark in the first half. Dansville with a 1-0 lead. Action also sponsored by Dansville Collision at 11 Spruce Street in Dansville, proud to support local sports. For all your collision and repair needs, dents, dings, or major collision damage, call Dave or Bridget Hoyg at 585-335-7700. It's Dansville Collision at 11 Spruce Street in Dansville, there when you need them. 13 minutes left to play. Ball will be thrown back in front of the Livonia bench by Dansville on the left side. Keeping it in over there, Bailey Hayes trying to feed it back down in the corner, but it's deflected out by the Livonia defense. I believe it was Kiara Wilson got a piece of that one. Substitutions, fresh bodies in for Jen Bugby's team. Livonia coming in at 1-2-1, including last night's game, so they're playing back-to-back nights. And then Thursday night they visit Haverling, and that is a 4:30 game. Ball sent back in by Dansville on the left side, quick touch pass in the middle. Kaylee Meyer with it, makes a move to the left. Does a little dance, brings it back in the middle. Ball taken away momentarily by the Livonia defense. And the ball winds up in the Bulldog bench, and throwing it back in over there, Callie Little, who has scored the game's only goal for the Dansville Lady Mustangs. The rain steadily falling right now, kind of a heavy drizzle right now as the umbrellas go up on the stands below us. Left side pass comes out front. Dansville controls it right in front of the Bulldog bench, and the ball ends up on the Bulldog bench, and Livonia will throw it back in. Action also sponsored in part by Nunday Lumber and Hardware at 11 South State Street in Nunday. They've been there for over 90 years, serving all your building and hardware needs. They've got everything you need for your home projects, from the foundation to the roof. Nunday Lumber and Hardware, 11 South State Street in Nunday. Ball checked back in. Livonia trying to go over the top of the Dansville defense, and the ball fouled off and chipped back. Going back after it, Treva Wadsworth trying to keep the Livonia pressure off. Sends it up near side, and a throw-in coming up for the Bulldogs. Blair Wallman has checked in for Livonia. Wilson with a long pass. Wallman with a touch. Fian trying to trigger a shot out front. Gets a piece of it from left to right. Fian, right-footed shot, deflected away, though. Emma Allen with a good tackle that time and knocked the ball away. Maya Hayes pushing a pass on the left-hand side. Making an approach far side, trying to circle the ball in. Ball comes into the middle of the box. Clock goes down in the box, collides with one of her own players, and a whistle. As Clock and one of the Dansville defenders also, it was one of the Livonia players also went down, as did one of the Dansville players, so it could have been three people who were involved in that. And it looks like it was Mary Kwok was one of them, and apparently everybody is okay, and from what we know, no penalty and no harm done at this point in time. But Kwok is back up, and that is a good thing. And with 10:21 left, it is a goal kick coming up. So apparently the ball must have wound up out of bounds last touch by Dansville. So Livonia gets the action back underway, and they send a long pass to midfield, where Dansville will try and center a pass out there by Eleni Montezores to the left side wing. Weaving her way back in, long pass comes all the way through, and Quack's going to come out and make the save. So for Mary, that's her third. Fifth shot credited to Dansville, 9:55 left. Action sponsored in part by the Leaning Tower at 124 Main Street in Dansville. Pizza, subs, wings, and a whole lot more. Looking for something unique or just something simple? Tasty classics galore at the Leaning Tower. Make them your go-to pizza joint. Give them a call at 585-335-2740. That's the Leaning Tower. Whistle as a corner kick coming up for Dansville on the far side. Dansville's second corner kick. It'll be Emma Allen with a right-footed shot from the left side corner, it looks like. 9:19 and counting down. Dansville with a 1-0 lead on a Callie Little goal at the 19:17 mark 10 minutes ago. So Allen triggers it off, boots it toward the near side post. Ball sent back out. Left footed shot by Chelsea Tyler goes wide. Goal kick coming up. 9 minutes left to play here in the first half. It's Dansville 1, Livonia nothing.
Comprehensive dental care exceeding customer expectations is what you'll get with Dr. Teachout at Dansville Family Dental Care, 191 Main Street in Dansville, where your smile is their top priority. To provide patients with the best care, the newest and most effective tools and techniques are employed. The team is composed of a highly trained and experienced staff dedicated to providing top quality dental service while maintaining a relaxing and positive environment for patients. Call Dr. Teachout at Dansville Family Dental Care today at 585-335-6170.
High school sports on WDNY.
Girls soccer action tonight is also sponsored in part by the Whalen American Legion on North Main Street in Whalen, proudly serving the area's veterans, service members, and the community. They're a proud supporter of high school sports, wishing both teams tonight the best of luck. Dansville with a 1-0 lead, a throw-in coming up for the Lady Mustangs. on the far side if they get it back in their own end. Livonia trying to start something offensively, and Olivia Feehan takes over on the right side with a quick touch pass. Gets it back in the middle. Bulldogs trying to pull the trigger there. Sophia Otis has the ball sent back out toward midfield. Right side pass is cut off over there by Chelsea Tyler, and the ball squirts to the right side wing. They try and go over the top now. Feehan tries to center a pass on top of the box, looking for a shot, but pressured by Emma Allen. Three defenders around her on the right side. Chelsea Tyler giving chase. Ball goes to the right side corner. They try to center the pass out front on the left side. It goes out behind the goal mouth. And let's see, did Livonia touch it last or Dansville? Dansville touched it last, the official says. So Olivia Feehan from the right side corner with a right-footed shot will take Livonia's third corner kick with 7 minutes left to play in this first half. Near side post, ball angling out in the middle, ball still loose in the box, finally sent back out on the right side. Bulldogs trying to control, but Dansville gets a piece of it and sends it back in the middle, but apparently there was a whistle, and it will be a restart for Dansville. Emma Allen will put it in play as the heavy drizzle continues to fall here at the reconfigured corral in Dansville. Dansville with a 1-0 lead, in case you've just joined us. Dansville and Livonia in girls soccer. Late in the first half, 6:20 and counting down, a Callie Little goal unassisted at the 19:17 mark, the difference in the game. Allen triggers it, sends it long and sent back in the middle. Controlling it near side, the Dansville Mustangs, and now Livonia takes over and they send it back on top. Weldy sends it back to the middle. That one is Hannah and Haley Weldy. Left side pass and ball cut off by Treva Wadsworth on the left side. Wilson, Kiera picks it up and throws it back in on the left side corner. Ball headed back out by the Dansville defense that time. Getting a piece of it there, Laney Montezores. Ball in the middle, ball knocked down out front. As jockeying for position, Brooke Schaefer for Livonia. Dansville trying to get it out of there, and they finally do on the left side. Long shot down the right side, and it's going to go out. Is it going to go out? No, Dansville's going to. Yep, they're going to let it go out. So goal kick coming up, 5:15 left. It's Dansville 1, Livonia nothing.
With over 30 years of experience, the Law Office of John C. Putney offers a wide range of quality legal services, including real estate, criminal, traffic violations, wills, family law, divorce, and business formation and counseling. For more information, call 585-335-2205 or visit jcputneylaw.com. That's jcputneylaw.com.
High school sports on WDNY.
Throw in coming up on the far side as Dansville, about 15 yards away, gets it in near the top of the box from the left side wing. They send it back out front, and Olivia Feehan picks it off and goes the other way for the orange and blue. Touch back in. Emma Allen got a piece of it. Kaylee Meyer reverses direction, feeds Allen. Allen, one right-footed shot is knocked down on the back line that time by Livonia. I believe it was Sophia Otis who might have got a piece in that. Rory Flickner was also back there. Livonia with a throw-in now off of that deflection. Right side, it's Blair Wallman trying to get it back in the middle. Feehan has the ball knocked back to the right side corner, giving chase back there defensively as Maya Hayes trying to start something for Dansville. Treva Wadsworth sends a long pass up over the top of the Livonia defense, headed back out by Avery Bernard. Bernard heads it back out, and Wadsworth comes up and challenges the ball again, and it's taken away by Kaylee Meyer, sent back in the middle. Ainsley Belcher feeds it in the middle to Chelsea Tyler, but Livonia breaks it up with a little header toward midfield. Mustangs trying to get something on the left-hand wing, and now it's sent back in the middle. Chelsea Tyler run off the ball by Olivia Feehan. Feehan with a good play that time before Chelsea Tyler could get into motion full speed. Ball squirts through, And Emma Allen with a touch pass to the far side for Callie Little, trying to take it up the left side wing. 3 minutes left to play here in the first half. The Innsville with a 1-0 lead in girls soccer. Midfield, Feehan takes it away. Darts up the right-hand side, challenging defensively. Taylor Hampshire on the far side, taking it to the end line. And down, Ainsley Belcher and Feehan both go. Infraction or no, apparently not. And coincidental contact, it looks like a throw-in coming up for Livonia in the right side as they will restart things there. And Jen Bugby will take an opportunity to put some fresh faces in the ball game as the rain continues to fall with a little over 2 minutes left to play in this first half. Kaylee Meyer with it for Dansville. Swings it right side. Sent back in by the Bulldogs. On the run, the left side, Kiara Wilson. And a whistle there. And a restart for the Livonia Bulldogs, apparently, on the left side. About 10 yards away on the left, free kick coming up for Olivia Feehan. Feehan, nope, they're going to leave it back out front for Avery Bernard. So it'll be Bernard from the left side, about maybe 12 yards away with a right foot, steers it up and over, and Butters is there for the save on the back post. So the Bulldogs get another shot away, but Emma Butters equal to the test. 10 saves in the game for Butters with a minute left to play here in this first half. Dansville trying to safeguard a 1-0 lead. Left side, long pass, left side, bodily contact. Ball gets away in the left. No whistle on the play, or is there? There is a stoppage of play there and a restart for Dansville just outside, about 30 yards away, and it looks like Emma Allen will pull the trigger on it with 41 seconds left to go. Allen, free kick from 30 yards out. So Allen, Mary Kwok in goal for Livonia, and here we go, 29 seconds, gets it up and over the top. Kwok makes the save. Kwok with her fourth, Dansville's sixth shot with 20 seconds left to play. Kwok will get the ball and send it back up the other way, and 10 seconds left, and if something's going to have to happen quick. Left side, and the pass steered into Livonia bench, and there's nothing going to happen as the first half expires here at the reconfigured corral in Dansville. We've come to the end of 40 minutes of play in girls soccer on homecoming week 2023 here on WDNY. Your score at halftime. It is the Dansville Lady Mustangs 1 and Livonia 0.
With over 30 years of experience, the law office of John C. Putney offers a wide range of quality legal services, including real estate, criminal, traffic violations, wills, family law, divorce, and business formation and counseling. For more information, call 585-335-2205 or visit jcputneylaw.com. That's jcputneylaw.com.
Michael Adam Insurance Agency, 168 Main Street in Dansville, is growing and would like to welcome Abby Sick to their agency. Now is the time to stop in and get a free quote. Call or stop by today. Their number is 585-335-ADAM. That's 585-335-2326. The Michael Adam Insurance Agency, offering protection for auto, home, farm, business, or life.
The next disaster is coming. The time to get ready is now. Make a plan. Identify meetup locations and people you'll need to contact. Put your contact list in your wallet, on your phone, and somewhere visible in your home. Build a kit. Store enough food and water for 3 days. Don't forget your pets. And consider buying a pre-made kit. Keep at least 7 days of medication on hand. Work with your pharmacist and insurance company to secure the extra doses. Make copies of important documents. Keep them on your phone, in the cloud, or on a USB stick. Stay informed. Learn about local hazards. Take courses in CPR and first aid. And sign up for local alert systems. An early warning can give you the time you need to prepare for a fast-moving disaster. Be ready. Learn more at americares.org/sendusin.
High school sports on WDNY.
We're at halftime here. Homecoming week 2023 on 105.7 WDNY. Girls soccer action. And the Livonia Bulldogs and Dansville getting together in a Livingston County Division I matchup. And it's all that it has been promised to be. A 1-0 contest at halftime here. Our halftime report sponsored by Phoenix Hearth and Power at 5 Maple Street in Dansville. They've got sales, service, and installation of gas, wood, and pellet stoves from makers such as Harmon, Lopi, and Vermont Castings. Follow them on Facebook for news, updates, and videos. The Whelan Food Mart, open 7 days a week for your shopping convenience. They've got what you need at great prices, plus a friendly staff to assist you, and a great deli, too, with hot and cold foods. That's the Whelan Food Mart, East Naples Street in Whelan. The Michael Adam Insurance Agency at 168 Main Street in Dansville. They've got protection for all of your needs, home, auto, life, recreational, farm, commercial. If you need insurance, call Michael Adam, 585-335-2326. Tonight's action also sponsored in part by Dansville Water Systems on the Hornell Road in Dansville, just south of 390 at exit 4. They can care of all of your water problems, whether it smells bad or has bacteria, is hard, leaves stains, whatever the problem. They also have pool and hot tub supplies, a well-stocked archery shop, and sheds are available, too, at Dansville Water Systems, just south of 390 at exit 4 on the Hornell Road in Dansville. Well, these two ball clubs right after it again. The Livonia Bulldogs, a little bit of momentum, a win and a tie in their last two ball games, although their last ball game was that tie last night in Penn Yan, a long night for Jen Bugby's team, but they have battled the Dansville Mustangs here. Dansville coming in after a 7-0 win over Warsaw the other night. Their only other victory was that 3-0 shutout of Letchworth earlier this season. They also have a game at hand with the Avon Braves that will be continued with 11:41 left to play on Wednesday. That's a week from tomorrow here at 6 p.m. They'll pick the game up and finish things off as Avon in Dansville, involved in a ball game a week or so ago, was stopped because of weather, thunder and lightning, and the game was suspended with a score of 3-0 in favor of the Dansville Lady Mustangs. That game, as we say, will be picked up next Wednesday night, starting at the 11:41 mark in the second half. In this ball game, it has been a back and forth battle. Early on, the Livonia Bulldogs peppered the Dansville goal mouth, but to no avail, as Emma Butters has been true to the test, the senior goalie, with 10 saves in the first half. And I think Livonia put the first 7 shots of the game on net. And of course, Butters managed to handle them all. Dansville finally got on the board just after the midway point of this first half. 19:17 left. A ball triggered off of a corner kick hit a defender and bounced back to the left side of the box, where Callie Little fired a 12-yard shot that found the back of the net amidst all of the traffic, and that has been it in this first half, 1-0 in favor of Dansville. Taking a look at the numbers thus far unofficially, Livonia has outshot Dansville 10-6 in the first half. Emma Butters with 10 saves for Dansville. Mary Kwok with 4 saves for the Livonia Bulldogs. Livonia with 3 corner kicks to Dansville's 2 as we enter the second half. But at any rate, certainly not a ball game that is out of question for either one of these two teams as we get set to start half number 2. Let us remind you as well, we have more homecoming action this week on 105.7 WDNY. Starting tomorrow with the tomorrow we will have live coverage of boys basketball act or boys soccer action here on 105.7 WDNY, as Dansville goes against Livonia, as the battle between the Dansville Mustangs and the Livonia Bulldogs continues tomorrow night right here on WDNY. Hope you will be with us then. Pre-game show at about 6:15, all the action at about 6:30, all right here on WDNY. Boys soccer action tomorrow night, and then we finish the week with football action live here from the reconfigured corral as the Geneva Panthers, who have outscored their opponents 80-0 in the first 2 weeks of football play, take on Dansville. And of course, Dansville fresh off that 3-0 win in the city over Virtus Charter on Saturday. We'll have to generate some offense there and a lot of defense. It should be a dandy. Pre-game show at 6:45, all the action at 7. That's Friday Night Football, homecoming style, right here on 105.7 WDNY. Well, we still have a second half of soccer action. Girls action coming your way in just a moment. Stay with us. Your score at halftime, it's Dansville 1, Livonia nothing.
There is no better and faster way to bring people together than delicious food everyone enjoys. Leaning Tower of Dansville make pizzas for every taste. So whether you're looking for something unique or just the simple but tasty classics, you can make Leaning Tower of Dansville your go-to pizza joint. Visit their website, leaningtowerofdansville.com, or give them a call at 585-335-2740.
Comprehensive dental care exceeding customer expectations is what you'll get with Dr. Teachout at Dansville Family Dental Care, 191 Main Street in Dansville, where your smile is their top priority. To provide patients with the best care, the newest and most effective tools and techniques are employed. The team is composed of a highly trained and experienced staff dedicated to providing top quality dental service while maintaining a relaxing and positive environment for patients. Call Dr. Teachout at Dansville Family Dental Care today at 585-335-6170.
Cloudy tonight with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm, low 60. Overcast tomorrow with a spotty shower, high 72. Mainly clear tomorrow night, low 50. Thursday, a bit of sun with a high of 69. Starlit sky Thursday night, low 47. Friday will start the weekend off pleasant, lots of sunshine and a high of 74. Friday night, clear skies, low 47. For weather anytime, go to AccuWeather.com. For AccuWeather, I'm Cheryl Golden.
At the Dansville Airport, it's 68 degrees.
High school sports on WDNY.
Now, second half soccer action is sponsored in part by Dansville Family Dental Care at 191 Main Street in Dansville. Comprehensive dental care exceeding customer expectations is what you'll get. Your smile is their top priority. Call Dr. Teachout and her staff today at 585-335-6170. And Dansville Chevrolet, find new roads to Dansville Chevrolet, located at 139 Franklin Street. They give great deals and outstanding customer service every day to everyone. See them today for your next vehicle. That's Dansville Chevrolet. So, second half set to get underway. The Dansville Mustangs will kick it off, and here we go. Dansville will be moving from right to left here in this second half. Livonia, the opposite direction. Ball squirts through the Livonia defense, putting some pressure on back there. Bailey Hayes takes the ball away and loses her footing on the wet facade down there, and a throw-in coming up for the Livonia Bulldogs as this second half gets underway here. Drizzle has let up just a bit right now, but still overcast skies and a threat of showers and, heaven forbid, thunderstorms. We've already had one game suspended, and that was that Avon game we made mention of at halftime. Throw in for Dansville, comes out front. Taylor Hampshire gets a piece of it, sends it back up the near side wing. Keeping it in is Bailey Hayes. Hayes tries to tuck it back down the left side to Callie Little, but ball broken up there by Hannah Weldy, who got a piece of it. Ball goes into the corner and losing it out. The Bulldogs, another throw in for Livonia. Her check, and it'll be a Dansville throw in for Callie Little, maybe about 10 yards wide of the box on the left side. Little in the left side corner tries to go up and over the top, sends it back out front. Hayes trying to circle it out front for a shot, reverses direction, now tries to take it to the middle. Hayes, looking for help, gets it from Taylor Hampshire, sends it down the left side. keeps it in. They try to center a pass out front, but the Bulldogs break it up on the far side. Good defense that time. Sophia Otis got a piece of it there for Livonia. They send it back out in the middle for Jen Bugbee's team over the top. Taylor Hampshire steers it on the near side. Callie Little tries to sneak it up the right side, but loses it, and a throw in coming up for the Livonia Bulldogs near midfield by Kendall Kretschmer, who is back in the lineup. Ball sent over the top, and now moving from left to right, Chelsea Tyler trying to chase it down, and on the far side, it's Megan Tyler trying to go wide left side. Chelsea Tyler in the middle, centers a pass out front. Kaylee Meyer accelerating down the middle. Left side passes deflected back out. Taylor Hampshire feeds left-hand side. Little trying to steer a pass in the middle, and it's knocked back out of there by Avery Bernard defensively for the Bulldogs. Little feeds a pass left side, gets it back on top, and refeeds Kaylee Meyer, and now Hampshire, left side wing, and the Bulldogs take it away. Bernard sends it in the middle, and Olivia Feehan leaves it for Bernard on the right side wing, trying to keep it in. Pass in the middle. With it there, Haley Weldy, but the ball cleared out of there by Emma Allen, left side, and Kiara Wilson sends it back in the left side corner. Foot race on for it there. Will it make it out? And it does, but it'll be a goal kick or a corner kick? Looks like a goal kick coming up. 36:45 left to play in the ball game. It's Dansville 1, Livonia nothing.
Dansville Auto Mart is proud to be a member of the Dansville business community and to bring one of the greatest selections of used automobiles to the area. The entire team is dedicated to meeting the needs of each customer in every way possible, changing the way you approach the automotive shopping process and helping you get into the right vehicle with affordable, flexible financing options. Stop by and see Jeff and the staff at 9976 Main Street or call 585-335-8280.
High school sports on WDNY.
Now Olivia Feehan gets a shot off in the box on the right side. One hopped by Emma Butters, who comes up with her 11th save of the game. 35-54 left. Dansville with a 1-0 lead as they look to go 3-0. Livonia at 1-2-1, but they have won and tied in their last two outings. So the momentum starting to reverse back for the Bulldogs. Jen Bugbee taking over last year for Mark Stevens as head coach. Kaylee Meyer checks out, checking in for Dansville. And it looks like it's Eleni Montezoris. Montezori gets her foot on the ball immediately. Ainsley Belcher with a quick pass to Wadsworth on the far side. Ball blocked momentarily, and Emma Allen clears it to midfield. Down the right side wing. On the run, Megan Tyler, and the ball sent back out by the Bulldog defense. Action here in the second half also sponsored by the Empire Realty Group. All real estate companies are not created equal. Empire Realty has unparalleled industry knowledge, expertise, and local expertise. Call 585-204-2440 or visit EmpireRealtyFingerLakes.com. Near side pass, ball touched by Callie Little, but trying to get after it there, Bailey Hayes. Livonia with a throw in. Kretschmer swings it up on the near side. Bernard gets a piece of it. Handball out front, I believe. Dansville will get a restart. Callie Little sends it back in, and Kretschmer gives it a touch up over the top. Is Chelsea Tyler sends it deep on the left-hand side. After it, Bailey Hayes, but the ball sent back out. Good defensive play by Michaela Probanich, the senior defender. Throw in coming up for Dansville for Callie Little on the left side wing. Gets it in out front. And the Bulldogs send it right back the other way. Another throw in coming up just about the same place for Callie Little. Gets it into the corner on the left side, and Hayes sends it back up over the top of the Bulldogs. Clear it back out. Avery Bernard sends it back in the middle, sent back in by Taylor Hampshire. Dansville trying to get something going offensively out front, but Bernard takes it away again. Taylor Hampshire sends it back in. Good defense there. Left side pass by Chelsea Tyler as Callie Little tries to keep it in but cannot do so. Official right on the line and the throw in coming up for Livonia. Action also sponsored in part by DWS Outdoors, a full-service archery and pro shop with top brands like Matthews, Bowtech, Elite Archery, and many more. They've got 10-point crossbows, targets, releases, and more. Visit them on the Hornell Road in Deansville, just south of 390 at Exit 4. Long pass on the far side. Eliza Parker after it, time to take it down the left side wing. She and Treva Wadsworth come together, and it looks like a throw-in coming up for Livonia on the far side. 32-52 and counting here. Some fresh faces in for the Lady Bulldogs. As the Livonia Bulldogs with a few more bodies to work with than the Danville roster that we were handed, maybe about five or six, but still those are valuable minutes for those players for sure. A long pass down the right side wing. On the run, Callie Little takes it to the right side corner. Tries to turn the corner. Right-footed shot. Kwok is there on the near post and takes it. Mary Kwok with her first save. Shots in the second half even, but overall, Livonia with 11, Danville with 7. Long pass down the right side, and of course, that's not the important part. The important part is that Danville leads the game 1-0. Ball squirts through in the box. A crossing pass, and Wadsworth finally sends it out over there. A couple of Bulldogs bearing down. It went right across in front of Emma Butters. So some miscommunication there almost cost the Mustangs right there, but no harm done with 31:46 left to play. Left side throw in for the Danville Lady Mustangs. In case you've just joined us, Danville with a 1-0 lead. The lone goal scored by Callie Little, unassisted, at the 19:17 mark of the first half. Quick touch pass over the top. Fian trying to get a shot away using a pick. Right-footed shot. Butters after it, and it's going to go wide. Goal kick coming up. 31:20 left to play in the ball game. It's Danville 1, Livonia nothing.
Danville Auto Mart is proud to be a member of the Danville business community and to bring one of the greatest selections of used automobiles to the area. The entire team is dedicated to meeting the needs of each customer in every way possible, changing the way you approach the automotive shopping process and helping you get into the right vehicle with affordable, flexible financing options. Stop by and see Jeff and the staff at 9976 Main Street or call 585-335-8280.
High school sports on WDNY.
Bulldogs outside the box. Left-footed shot goes wide by Avery Bernard. 30-30 left to play here in the second half. Danville with a 1-0 lead. In action also sponsored in part by the fine folks at Danville Chevrolet. Wishing best of luck to both teams. Next time you need a vehicle, be sure to stop by Danville Chevrolet, where they give great deals and outstanding customer service every day to everyone. See them today for your next vehicle. So Ainsley Belcher roots it out on the right-hand side. Whistle and a stoppage of play. Restart for Danville on that side. Oh, the Mustangs put it in play just shy of the midfield stripe. I believe it's Ainsley Belcher with it out there, if I'm not mistaken. To see the numbers from our angle right here. It is Ainsley. Puts the right foot to it and sends it deep down the right side wing. Megan Tyler giving chase toward the end line, trying to steer it past the in. She does so. Right footed shot just goes wide of the goal mouth by Maya Hayes. So is it a goal kick coming up or a corner kick? Did Livonia get a piece of it? Apparently Livonia got a piece of it. It'll be a corner kick as Emma Allen headed to the corner on the far side on the right. Right-footed shot from the right foot, right side corner with 29:11 left. Danville's third corner kick. That's stat even on both sides. So Allen with the approach, the right-footed shot from the right side corner steers it up toward the near post. Ball tipped away by Kwok. Left side pass. Ball knocked away and finally cleared out by Livonia. On the backside doorstep, Bailey Hayes got a piece of that one and almost got a chance to knock it in from the doorstep. So the Mustangs get the shot, but Kwok with the save. So Dansville, credit them with their eighth shot of the game. Near side, Livonia tries to exploit the right sideline. Taylor Hampshire goes back and gets a piece of it. Throw-in coming up for the Bulldogs. Hannah Weldy gets it in very quickly. And the ball back out front. Emma Allen clearing it to midfield to Kaylee Meyer. And the ball sent back down by Livonia. And Dansville throw-in coming up. Action also sponsored in part by Quinlan's Pharmacy and Medical Supply. More than just a pharmacy, they've got four convenient locations to serve you in Wayland, Geneseo, Canandaigua, and Montour Falls. They can take care of all your health care needs for your entire family. Throw-in check. It is a Livonia throw-in. Avery Bernard gets it in. Ball bodied down, and Olivia Feehan had it momentarily, and Kaylee Meyer goes to the wet turf. Trying to save it in. Not as bad as the mud puddles in the old field, so that is for sure. And I bet these players appreciate that. Left-footed shot, near side, post, and wide. Oh, pulling the trigger that time. Haley Weldy, but just missed wide left. Goal kick coming up. Dansville puts it back in play with 27 minutes left to play in the ball game. Dansville with a 1-0 lead as Emma Butters clears it out on the right side wing. Gets it back in the middle. Battling for it out front. Mustangs send it up left side. Foot race in progress on the left. Closing on it quickly, Bailey Hayes and Maya Hayes also. Whistle and the ball goes across the near touchline and it'll be thrown back in by Dansville. Callie Little will toss it in. It is Callie's goal, which is the difference in this ball game at the 19-17 mark of the first half. Ball bodied in by Avery Bernard. Trying to body it down there is Ainsley Belcher, and now Hampshire sends it up for Dansville. Kretschmer with a quick touch, and now Otis sends it back, and Belcher sends it back the other way. It'll be a throw-in for Livonia. Action also sponsored in part by Hober Sealing of Wayland. They can make that old driveway look new again. They offer asphalt repair, maintenance, crack filling, and striping. Call 585-728-5650 to find out more. That's Hober Sealing of Wayland. Left side pass to midfield. Sent back, and Dansville trying to clear it out of their end. They do so successfully at midfield as Maya Hayes got a piece of it, but Livonia sends it back in near side. Hustling on it, Callie Little that time as she and Avery Bernard came together, but it'll be a Livonia throw-in. Action here in the second half, also sponsored in part by Phoenix Hearth and Power at 5 Maple Street in Dansville. With sales, service, and installation of gas, wood, and pellet stoves from makers such as Harman, Lopi, and Vermont Castings. Follow them on Facebook for news, updates, and videos. Phoenix, Hearth and Power. One of the Bulldogs down at midfield. Not sure got a piece of the ball, or when she went down, maybe hit her face on the turf. And back up is Haley Weldy. And no worse for wear. And the junior midfielder says, I'm okay, and hustles back in there, and that's a good thing. 24-40 left to play, and the ball will be booted back in by Livonia, by Avery Bernard. Ball squirts through to the back line, left side. Bulldogs trying to make an offensive opportunity out of it. Ball knocked away midfield, and coming up with it, Bailey Hayes sends it back on the right side. Megan Tyler trying to turn the corner on the far side, does, sends a long pass up front for Maya Hayes, the eighth grader, and the Bulldogs take it away at midfield, left to right, pass comes to the right side, wing squirts through in the back, and Callie Little with it, trying to steer it near side, but nobody at home, and Livonia will throw it back in from about 25 yards away. Don't forget boys soccer action tomorrow night. Same two teams, Livonia and Dansville. Pregame at about 6:15. All the action at 6:30 right here on 105.7 WDNY. Hope you'll join us then. Olivia Feehan leaves it out front. Kretschmer trying to exploit the top of the box. Emma Allen deflects it away on the right-hand side. Eleni Montezoris sends it out there as well. And now Megan Tyler sends it deep for Maya Hayes, but it's picked off by Livonia, who sends it the other way. Bulldogs outside the box, making an approach on the right side. Quick pass goes through the crease. Callie Little with it in the backside, trying to take it to the sideline on the left. Ball deflected out front. Fien with it and sends a pass on the right side. Olivia Fien has got several of Livonia's 14 shots, and she has been quite accurate with them, so she has tested Emily Butters herself many times in this ball game. So Lainey Montezoris checks out, and Mustangs will send Chelsea Tyler back to the action. So Chelsea back in there now. Tyler challenging for the ball immediately, and the ball sent up on the right-hand side. Kiara Wilson and Megan Tyler on the far sideline trying to get after it as both number fours. Caitlin Haw and Treva Wadsworth go at it, and the ball goes out of bounds into the Bulldogs bench on the far sideline, both after that loose ball defensively. Action here in the second half, also sponsored in part by the Whalen Food Mart on East Naples Street in Whalen. They got what you need at great prices. They also have a deli with great hot and cold foods, too. Friendly folks at the Whalen Food Mart, East Naples Street in Whalen, serving you 7 days a week. And one of the Bulldogs goes down, lost a footing on that wet turf. And that's the second time here in the second half. Right now, doesn't seem to be any precipitation falling, but the rain did come down pretty steadily in a drizzly form late in the first half. So a restart for Livonia. And Avery Bernard sends it deep on the left side, and Emma Butters will track it down. The shot goes way wide for Livonia, their 15th shot, to Dansville's 8. Thus far in the game, Emma Butters with 11 saves, Mary Kwok with 6. Left side pass, and out of there is Sophia Otis, the ninth grade midfielder, sends one back, deflected by Taylor Hampshire, trying to get it out on the right side wing. Chelsea Tyler after it, but Livonia trying to tuck it in the corner and make an offensive opportunity out of it. They swing it back toward the top, trying to get it to Olivia Fien, and she has it out front now, trying to make a move there. Takes it away and comes to the right-hand side. Right-footed shot by Fien. One hop and save by Emma Butters. So once again, Olivia Fien gets a shot off, but Emma Butters with her 12th save of the game, her second of the second half. Long pass on the left-hand side. Livonia has gotten six shots away in the second half, but only a couple of them on goal. Right side, Bernard sends a pass in the right side wing, and Kaylee Little sends a long pass near side. Bailey Hayes on the run, but a little bit too hot to handle there, and Livonia will toss it back in. Action also sponsored in part by the Michael Adam Insurance Agency on Main Street in Dansville. They've got insurance protection for all your needs, life, home, auto, recreational, farm, commercial. Call Michael and his staff today at 585-335-2326. The Michael Adam Insurance Agency, Main Street in Dansville. Livonia sends a long pass back toward the top as Hannah Weldy comes up. And now, once again, taking it is Olivia Fien. Fien on the right-hand side, the sophomore, goes wide, steers a pass in the middle. Ball deflected into the box. Left-footed shot saved by Butters with a diving save right on the doorstep. Left-side pass comes back in out front, cleared out of there. Butters with a dandy of a save right there. That ball squirted through, and one of the Bulldogs on the back line had a chance on the doorstep, got a shot toward the goal mouth, and Butters, with a literal diving stop, deflected it away. So a corner kick now coming up for Livonia, their first of the second half, and Olivia Fien, right-footed shot from the left side corner, 18:44 left as Livonia putting the pressure on Dansville. Angles one in there. Ainsley Belcher sends it back out toward the Bulldog bench. Throw in coming up for Livonia about 20 yards away on the left-hand side. As they get it back in. Left side, and Treva Wadsworth sends it right back out. 18:22 and counting. Dansville with a 1-0 lead late in this second half. Ainsley Belcher trying to get it back up the right side wing, and it's going to go out again near the Livonia bench, and the Bulldogs will throw it back in over the top. Bernard, long shot taken by Emma Butters, and that time about a 25-yard shot put up that time by Avery Bernard, and Butters comes down with her 14th save on the right side. Trying to keep her footing there is Eliza Parker for Livonia. Pass out front, and it's Olivia Feehan again. Feehan up the right side wing as the ball steered out from behind. Kaylee Meyer there, and a throw-in coming up for Dansville. I believe it's Kaylee Little who will throw it in. Chelsea Tyler checks out. And we'll see who's checking back in. It looks like Eleni Montezores. Ball goes toward the right side corner, and Kelly Little will toss it in with 17 minutes left to play in the ball game. Tomorrow night, boys soccer, Livonia and Dansville, pregame at 6:15. High school football Friday night, homecoming style. Dansville, Wayland, Cohocton. DWC against Geneva. Pregame show at 6:45. All the action at 7 right here on 105.7 WDNY. Long pass in the back. After it there, Michaela Probanich, and applying the pressure over there was Emma Allen, looking to get a piece of that ball, and it sent out on the far side. A throw-in coming up, and it was last touched by Livonia. Mustangs will throw it back in with 16:24 left and a 1-0 lead. And Belden's team trying to defend that one-goal lead and move to 3-0 as their next game will be on Thursday night here against Naples. It'll be senior night, so congratulations to the senior members of this Dansville team. Emma Butters, Cameron Rittenhouse, Callie Little, Treva Wadsworth, Faith Mutchler, Kaylee Meyer, Chelsea Tyler, Ainsley Belcher, Emma Allen, and Madison Forrester will all be honored prior to the game. Naples Big Green on Thursday. Ball back out front. Kaylee Meyer with it, sends it near side. Trying to stay with it. Bailey Hayes lost her footing. Ball sent back in deep. Taylor Hampshire after it and sends it out. A throw-in coming up for Livonia. Maybe about 10 yards away on the right side, down to 15:20 left to play. Eliza Parker checks out for Livonia. And the Bulldogs make that substitution. Avery Bernard with a long pass. It's Sophia Otis who checks back in. Long pass on the left side is run down by Emma Butters, who comes out of the goal mouth and boots it out of there with less than 15 minutes left to play in this game. At the reconfigured corral here in Dansville. Left side wing, Kaylee Meyer with it, steering a pass in the middle. Livonia breaks it up, though. Bernard sends it back near side as Haley Kuhn comes up, but Sophia Otis gives it up out front. Olivia Feehan with a quick touch pass deflected on the right side. Kuhn with it once again on the right side wing, trying to push it back toward midfield, and the ball deflected out by Kaylee Meyer. Action also sponsored in part by the Wayland American Legion on North Main Street in Wayland, where they serve the area's veterans, service members, and the community, and they're a proud sponsor of high school sports. That's the Wayland American Legion on North Main Street in Wayland. Near side, long pass for Bailey Hayes into the corner. Foot race on Maya Hayes, the eighth grader, closing on it along with Michaela Probanich, and the ball goes out. Will it be a corner kick or is it a goal kick? Looks like it will be a goal kick. 13:50 left to play in the ball game. It's Dansville 1, Livonia nothing.
Craving pizza and wings? Call Tony's Pizzeria, 585-335-8984 for carry out or dine in. Freshly made tasty subs, soups, and salads, as well as a kids menu, make Tony's Pizzeria a one-stop restaurant for your family. Dough, sauce, soups, and meatballs are made fresh at our 140 Main Street Dansville restaurant. Call 585-335-8984 to order. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Tony's Pizzeria Dansville. High school sports on WDNY.
Pass comes through the box, goes over the top, shot is! Is it a goal or did it go over the top? Goal, the scoreboard shows, so the ball did go in the net. It looked like Mary Kwok went up, and I'm not sure who that goal was credited to. We'll have to wait and see. Kaylee Meyer at the 13:08 mark. So Kaylee Meyer, I'm not sure. I don't believe there was an assist on that. So Kaylee Meyer makes it a 2-0 game. One of the Dansville Mustangs is down past the far post, being attended to by the Dansville staff over there. Megan Linsner and Aaron Belden both there. Not sure who it is who is down. But there was a pileup in the back there, and it was Kaylee Meyer who got a piece of that ball on the near side. I want to say it was probably a good 12 to 15 yard shot. Not sure. I don't believe there was an assist on the play, but Dansville has doubled their lead now at 2-0 with 13:08 left to play in the ball game. Well, there's a break in the action here. 13:08 left to play at the reconfigured corral. It's Dansville 2, Livonia nothing.
Better Homes, located at 13 Ocean Street in Dansville, has something for every room in your home. They have all the name brands and the experience to help you make the right choice. They have Lazy Boy, England, Ashley, and White Dove chiropractic bedding. They have floor coverings, furniture, and so much more. Visit them online at betterhomesdansville.com. And remember, when it's time to get new furniture, bedding, or floor covering, the place to go is Better Homes, located at 13 Ocean Street, Dansville.
Jim from Dansville Muffler and Brake wishes both teams the best of luck. And the next time you need quality work done on your vehicle, see Dansville Muffler and Brake. With a 4.7 Google rating, you can trust the professionals at Dansville Muffler and Brake to get the job done quickly and right the first time. Dansville Muffler and Brake is located just off Main Street at 9 Spruce Street, and their number is 585-335-8860.
High school sports on WDNY.
So, injured Mustang up. Maya Hayes limping off a little bit, but at least under her own power, so that is a good thing. So Maya, the eighth grade forward, not going quite as fast as she normally does, but at any rate, it is good to see her back up under her own power and making her way off the field on the far sideline. Warm hand from the fans on hand. 13:08 left in the ball game. Dansville with a two-goal lead as Hannah Weldy gets things rolling again for the Livonia Bulldogs. Long pass toward the seam up front. Right side clearing it out is Eleni Montezoris on the far side. It ends up in the Mustang bench where Livonia will throw it in. So Callie Little and Kaylee Meyer, the Callie-Kaylee combination, with the two goals in this ball game tonight. Dansville with a 2-0 lead. Near side after it is Kaylee Meyer, who nailed that last goal from the left-hand side from about 15 yards out, found the mark. I believe Mary Kwok might have even got a hand on that, but the ball was headed toward the top shelf on the far post and found the back of the net. So Kaylee Meyer with the goal, And a 2-0 Dansville lead. In the back, Ainsley Belcher pops it over the top. Ball headed back up by Kendall Kretschmer. Throw-in coming up for Livonia. It's Haley Weldy. No, check it. It's a Dansville throw-in. Kelly Little gets it in. Left side pass deflected back out front. Taken there by Hannah Weldy. Sending it back in the middle. Bulldogs clear it up and over. Ainsley Belcher giving chase for Dansville on the far side and sends it toward the wing where Megan Tyler tracks it down over there. Tries to make something out of it, but Livonia sends it back out. No, it was last touched by Dansville, so Livonia will throw it in about 10 yards out on the far side, 11:25 and counting. Quick pass over the top, left side corner. And steered out. It'll be a throw-in coming up for Dansville. Action also sponsored in part by the Leaning Tower at 124 Main Street in Dansville. Whether you're looking for something unique or just the simple, tasty classics like pizza, subs, wings, you can make the Leaning Tower of Dansville your go-to pizza joint. Give them a call at 585-335-2740 or log on to leaningtowerofdansville.com and order online. Long pass up the right-hand side. Olivia Feehan breaks it up and takes control for Livonia on the left-hand side. They have been trying to get the ball on her foot all night long, and Jen Bugby certainly knows that she is a dangerous commodity, and she is only a sophomore. She has had several shots on goal on the money tonight in this ballgame. So on the far side, throw-in coming up. Will be a Livonia throw-in, I believe, or is it? No, it's a Dansville throw-in right in front of the Livonia bench, however. Ball comes up in the middle, and on the far side, it's Rory Flickner who got a piece of it for Livonia. Dansville trying to get it in there. Caitlin Haw and Treva Wadsworth trying to battle for position over there. It's going to be a Tonight's action also sponsored in part by Dansville Family Dental Care at 191 Main Street in Dansville. Comprehensive dental care exceeding customer expectations is what you'll get. Your smile is their top priority. Call 585-335-6170 today. On the near side, the Bulldogs trying to make an approach. They send it back into the middle as the Weldy girls try to get something going, but Ainsley Belcher sends it right back out. Near side throw in coming up for Livonia, and substitutions will take place on both sides. Looks like Cameron Rittenhouse has checked into the game for the Dansville Mustangs. Pass on the near side. Goes across the sideline, and Dansville will throw it in. Kaylee Meyer does the honors, and Kretschmer breaks it up as Chelsea Tyler was looking for that pass, but Kretschmer stepped in the way. Meyer gives it back in the middle. Livonia trying to take it down. Ball taken out front that time by Bailey Hayes, and now taken away by Bernard. Bernard sends a long pass up the left side wing, but Treva Wadsworth corrals it there for Dansville, trying to get it to Cameron Rittenhouse. The ball volleyed back the other way for Dansville. And the Bulldogs take over. Kirsten Einhippel with a pass to the left-hand side, and the Bulldogs reverse it back to the right. In the middle, touched there by Bailey Hayes momentarily. Bulldogs on the left side wing send it long, but it's going to go out. Dansville throw-in coming up with 8 minutes left to play in the game. Action tonight also sponsored in part by Nunday Lumber and Hardware on South State Street in Nunday. They have been serving the area for over 90 years with building supplies galore. Next time you have a project, be sure to start at Nunday Lumber and Hardware. They've got everything you need from the foundation to the roof. Nunday Lumber and Hardware, 11 South State Street in Nunday. Ball in on the left-hand side. Bulldogs chasing it down at midfield on the left-hand side. Michaela Prabanich sends it back to midfield. Ball knocked down over there. Treva Wadsworth hustles up, but will it be a Livonia throw? It is a Livonia throw, and it was Treva that touched it last. So Avery Bernard with a throw or a check, and it's a restart right at the 50-yard line. So from midfield, Avery Bernard will contact the ball, sends a low liner to the top of the box. It's volleyed back out of there by Kaylee Meyer, who scored the game's second goal. Dansville with a 2-0 lead. In the back, long pass by Emma Allen up the right side wing. Kaylee Meyer on the run after it, and Livonia will let it go out. Kaylee will toss it in from the far sideline. 6:41 left to play in the ball game. Dansville with a 1-0 lead. Oh, Aaron Belden makes a substitution over there on the sideline as well. The ball thrown back in and volleyed back out, but it was last touched by Dansville, they said. Action here in the second half, also sponsored in part by Tony's Pizzeria. Open Tuesday through Sunday, serving lunch and dinner. Save time and order in advance. Even when dining in, call 585-335-8984. Tony's Pizzeria at 140 Main Street in Dansville. I tell you, just think about that, and I get hungry, and I hope you do too. Up the right side wing, Dansville on an approach, trying to take it along the end line, and the ball goes out on the far side. I believe it was Megan Tyler after it over there, and I believe it will be a throw-in for Dansville. I think it's Callie Little who was over there to toss it in. Gets it in on the near side. They pop it up in the box toward the top of the box. After it there for the Mustangs, Savannah Webster, and ball sent back out in the middle, and it's Olivia Feehan. Feehan with a long pass on the right side wing. Emma Butters is going to come out of goal and deflects it to the left side wing. Taylor Hampshire gets a piece of it, but stepping in there and taking it away, Haley Weldy. Weldy loses it. It's a throw into Dansville. And Bailey Hayes with it sends it back out front and taking it away, Haley Weldy. Weldy with a pass in the middle out front. Pass down the left side, Kiara Wilson, left side, left-footed shot, deflected out by Ainsley Belcher, will trigger a corner kick coming up for Livonia, their fifth of the game to Dansville's three. So Livonia will put the ball in play from the far side. I believe it is Kendall Kretschmer with a right-footed shot from the left side corner, 4:29 and counting. Hooks one out front. Cameron Rittenhouse gets a piece of it. It sends it into the box. Ball popped up, and Butters knocks it away. Ball bodied down. Ball still loose. A whistle, and it is saved by Butters. Butters comes up with another dandy of a save there. Her 15th on the doorstep. 4:01 left to play. Bulldogs banging on the door, but Emma Butters won't let him in. Long pass comes over the top. Livonia again has time on Dansville's side with 3:46 left to play in the game. Dansville with a 2-0 lead. Left side pass. It will be a Livonia throw in from the far side. Down in the left side corner and tracking it down and booting it out. Ainsley Belcher on the far side. Livonia will throw it again in again about 10 yards away. They bring it back out front with 3:17 left as Rittenhouse challenges the ball and it's sent back up again. Dansville throw in this time? I believe so. Action also sponsored by Dansville Collision at 11 Spruce Street in Dansville. Major or minor collision damage, no problem. Call 585-335-7700. Dansville Collision, 11 Spruce Street in Dansville. Webster out front on top of the box. She and Bernard come together on the top of the box. A whistle. And it will be a restart for Livonia. Just outside the Dansville are just outside the Bulldog box at the other end of the field, so they got a long way to go, but free kick coming up, and Avery Bernard gets play back underway, boots it toward midfield. Ball squirts through the back. And Dansville looking to clear it out back there, and they do so as Treva Wadsworth got a foot on it. Livonia will toss it back in with 2:14 left toward the top of the box. Ball sent back out by Bailey Hayes. They send it across the middle. Right side scuffed pass. Squirts through the crease. Coming out after it. Utters smothers it outside of the goal mouth. And will boot it back out of there with less than 2 minutes to play in this ball game. So Butters will get it out of there. Action also sponsored in part by Dogwood Floral. Flowers say so much. Dogwood Floral on Main Street in Dansville. They've got the knowledge and expertise to take the stress out of sending flowers. Call 585-335-5175 or visit them at dogwoodfloralcompany.com. Fian tries to get a shot away, but Emma Allen deflects it, goes to the left side wing and across the touchline. Who touched it last? That's the question. It will be a goal kick coming up, so Livonia touched it last. 1:16 left to play and the clock running down. Dansville with a 2-0 lead as Emma Butters will boot it out of there from her end right about at the 1 minute mark. 1 minute remaining and the long pass out front volleyed back in by Livonia. Belcher in the back, left side pass hits the side of the net. 10th shot for Livonia, but a goal kick coming up again. Action also sponsored in part by Dansville Muffler and Brake at 9 Spruce Street in Dansville. When your vehicle needs repairs, call Jim Hart, 585-335-8860, a proud sponsor of high school athletics. That's Dansville Muffler and Brake. 29 seconds left to play, and Emma Allen will get play underway back at midfield. Megan Tyler gets a piece of it, and so does Savannah Webster, but Livonia will get a throw in at midfield with 13 seconds left to play. Ball comes back in near side, and we're inside of 10, ladies and gentlemen, right side corner. Ball taken down the left side and out of play. And ladies and gentlemen, the Livonia Bulldogs and the Dansville Mustangs have come to a conclusion here at the reconfigured corral. And the Dansville Mustangs emerge victorious. Your final score tonight in girls soccer. The Dansville Lady Mustangs 2, the Livonia Bulldogs 0. We'll be back to wrap it up for you in just a moment.
Dansville Collision has been doing business for over 29 years. That means they must be doing something right. From minor to major repairs, they're your one-stop shop. Their pricing is fair and the work, outstanding. Put the experience of Dansville Collision to work for you. If you're looking for mechanical work from New York State inspections to anything else, see Bridget or Dave at 11 Spruce Street in Dansville or call 585-335-7700. That number again, 585-335-7700.
Empire Realty Group, locally owned and operated within the Dansville and Livonia communities, is not your typical run corporate agency. With our local knowledge and industry experience, Empire Realty Group is the team for you. In this competitive market, you will not be disappointed when you choose to team up with an Empire agent. Whether you're thinking of buying or selling, call 585-204-2440.
Empire Realty Group is a proud supporter of high school sports on hometown.